Pennsylvania Avenue in Washington, D.C. has been called America's Main Street. Every 4 years, the artery between the White House and the U.S. Capitol is the site of an inaugural parade. But the rest of the time, like many urban streets, it's full of cars. Until recently, bicycle commuters had to share the busy street with those cars, and bike commuter Kia Chatterjee used to avoid it.
So I used to bicycle along the river, not a direct path at all to my office. A scenic path, but not a direct path.
In 2010, D.C. reconfigured the avenue, adding bike lanes down the middle separated by pylons. The idea was to encourage more people to bike rather than drive to work. That interested Washington University in St. Louis researcher Aaron Hipp.
My research is in built environment and how people interact in outdoor environments, specifically parks, but also streets, sidewalks, plazas, and around buildings. And so if a city puts in a bike lane, do people use it? You know, if you build it, do they come?
With computer scientist Robert Pless, Hipp found a novel way to test these questions. Since 2006, Pless has curated an online archive of images from 23,000 publicly available webcams. And it just so happened that one of those was a traffic camera at 9th Street and Pennsylvania Avenue.
Knowing that he had this and that was ongoing, I became really interested. And because it was archival, knowing that you could find an area like DC that has added bike share, that has added crosswalks and bike lanes, it's fine and well to think about what this means for active transportation and human interaction now, but we don't really have the baseline data. And he essentially has some of that baseline data by having these photos since 2006.
The researchers looked at the number of pedestrians, bikers, and cars in a sample of webcam images taken every half hour for 1 week in June, during the year before the bike lanes went in, and the year after. They found a significant increase in the number of bikers after the bike lanes went in. They also found an interesting weather-related change.
One of the interesting findings was actually, it was found by one of our master's students. She did this as her thesis project. And she found that when it rained before the built environment changed, so when it rained before you had the zebra print crosswalk and you had the bike lane, that the number of cyclists and walkers present decreased. But she found that after those additions, so after a painted crosswalk and after a bike lane were present, that those numbers did not decrease. So to us, that means if you have an infrastructure there, it provides a sense of safety. That was really our take home from that.
Kaya Chatterjee agrees and says that the increased sense of safety has led many of her coworkers to start biking to work.
Really, for me, one of the biggest differences is that it has made so many other people bicycle that it's made it way safer on a bike because of the numbers, really, and because cars are getting used to the idea there are bikes around them, and it's just becoming so much easier and so much more popular. It seems like almost by the day in D.C.
Now, Hipp plans to use the webcams to study how other changes in the built environment affect people's behavior. He hopes the work will help policymakers figure out how to design cities to increase physical activity levels.
So there's a lot of physical activity policies, whether safe routes to schools, so providing kids easy or safer access to walk or bike to school. There's complete street policies, where when you redesign or redevelop a street, you take into account not just personal vehicles, but public transportation, walking and biking. There's also simple things like shade, adding street art, adding benches. I really feel like it's just like a candy jar of questions. It's really for us now to think through, all right, so what's really important and what is actually changeable?